guys, welcome to Sherry's show. Today, we're with Sherry again. I have you guys ask for Sherry so many times. When Sherry's gonna come to the show, Here she is. Say hi.
Hi, everyone.
Well, what did you do? Did you pay everyone to ask
you? I did. I did every single one of them. I bribed everyone.
So what's cooking today, Sherry?
We're gonna make some Mediterranean appetizers today. We're making hummus.
Are you guys ready? Let's cook hummus together.
For hummus, we need, of course, chickpea, because hummus actually means chickpea.
In
Arabic.
Oh, in Arabic. Yeah. So I know that in Greece they make hummus, and then Turkey, I know part of Turkey they're European and part of Turkey they're Middle Eastern. And then they make hummus too, but mostly hummus are from...
As far as I know, it originated in Egypt.
Egypt.
And so that's why in Arabic, I guess they call it hummus.
Hummus
in Arabic, yeah.
Hummus means chickpea in Arabic, but but Greek people make it, and also Turkish people make it, and most Mediterranean
dishes
countries
have it, and the side dish, yes, exactly.
Okay.
So the main part is chickpea.
Chickpeas.
I like to put garlic salt or garlic powder in it as well, but we definitely put real garlic in it too. Tahini, which is sesame paste.
Yeah.
Paprika.
And then I know tahini, mostly Turkish people and Arab people put tahini in there.
Yeah, it's yummy. It actually makes it very creamy and oily, right? And you definitely want tahini in it. Some people put other stuffs. A friend of mine told me she puts yogurt in it.
Oh.
But the original recipe doesn't have yogurt. Lemon juice, fresh squeezed lemon juice.
Of course.
Changes it. Parsley is just to garnish, some olive oil, and that's it. And we just process everything.
And then salt and pepper for taste.
Taste as you
and
wish.
And we have garlic, and then that's it.
That's it, yeah.
Okay, let's do it.
Let's do it?
Yeah.
Let's do it. All right, so first, we're going to process our chickpeas.
That's a cute processor.
Yeah.
Small and cute, yeah. Mine is huge.
Yeah, I have a big one too, but we only need one can. We're gonna make one can. If you wanna make more, you can. Yeah. Also, I use the bigger can. I have smaller ones too. So I'm gonna process this. It's gonna make a little bit of a noise.
Yeah, this is for four people, maybe?
Yeah. I like to eat it all by myself. So I like to pulse it first, and then scrape it down. After you add all the ingredients, then you should pulse it longer. So now I'm gonna add the rest of the ingredient, but I like to actually grind my garlic in there, right? Because when you put it in there, it might be a bit chunky. So for one can, I'm putting two garlic. So I'm gonna give this to you, I'm sorry.
Thank you, that's my bowl for now.
Yeah, I'm gonna give all your hummus in there. Yeah, so we're just going to grind our garlic. It doesn't wanna stay. Okay, come on garlic. Come
stay
on
where
garlic,
you are.
Stay, that's right. Doesn't want me to cook it. You know what it is? It's because I can't see.
Oh, there you go.
There you
go.
Now I can see.
Hey, I can see you better now, too. That you wear your glasses.
There you go. See, that's what it is. Okay. So let's just do that. I wish you guys could smell this. Yum. I love
the
smell.
You like me. Whenever I'm actually, you know, grinding garlic.
It's so good, right? And it's so good for you. Sorry, I'm not fast. Actually,
no,
I am pretty
you
fast.
Are pretty fast.
What am I saying?
Yeah, remember, our audiences want to see you again, so you must have done something.
Yeah, they want to see my nails. That's what it is. I don't even know how I'm grinding these, but anyways, let's see. Okay, good. So we're good there. So we're going to put our garlic in there.
So two cloves of garlic.
And then we're gonna squeeze
your lemon juice.
A lemon.
I like it. You could put lime too if you want, right?
Lemon is better.
Lemon is better because
lime is too sour. Gets too sour. So let's see. For now, I'm putting a few teaspoons in there.
Of course.
Gonna put paprika in there.
Oh, okay. Just for the kick.
It changes the
taste. Just a little bit.
Too much. Mm-hmm. A pinch. Again, we give the proper amount.
What's that?
This is our garlic powder.
Oh, garlic powder. So you put garlic and garlic powder. Okay.
It tastes different.
Okay.
Yeah, and then.
And then tahini.
Let's use the smaller one for tahini. So about a tablespoon of tahini. Yeah.
They can get any, if they want to get tahini, where they can buy tahini?
Any grocery store.
Oh,
any grocery store have it. Yeah, it's very popular.
Yeah.
So let's pulse this and see what's going on. I'm just gonna bring it down. Now some people put yogurt in it. I said my friend said she put yogurt in it to make it creamier.
I never put yogurt in.
I haven't tried.
But
some people put ice cube. They say ice cube puppet process. Mm. So what I'm gonna do is right now open one of these because I forgot to actually keep some of the juice in there.
Oh, I see.
Right,
you
got rid of all of it.
All
yeah, you're not supposed to fully drain it. I made a mistake, but that's okay.
That's okay.
You guys
You caught your mistake right away.
Yeah.
The bowl?
No, just a spoon. So I'm gonna just put a little bit in there, like a tablespoon. Mm-hmm. And now it's going to process and it kind of becomes silky.
I know some people put cumin in there.
Yes, they do. People put cumin. Yeah. I don't. I only put... So the actual original recipe is very simple. It's what we just put, right? Mm-hmm. But people do actually, you're right, they put cumin in it. Yeah, should be good now. There you go.
Oh, it looks creamy.
Creamy, right?
Yeah.
And that's it, done. Now we can
put it in your bowl.
Put in our dish. The best thing to do is let it sit in the fridge for a while.
Mm-hmm. Maybe 10 minutes or?
I like to leave it half an hour. Mm-hmm. But if you really want to eat it right away, you go ahead.
And then do you put olive oil on top after that?
Yes, so you can decorate it.
Mm-hmm. Do you put olive itself too? Like, you know,
some of the, not olive, no. So I put my hummus in a dish and I put a few chickpeas on top, mm-hmm. olive oil and some paprika.
Oh,
yeah.
Nice.
So this is the way I make it is just,
And it's such an easy, happy to make, especially when you have guests over and you have tons of stuff to make. Yeah. This is easy to make, so you could just put that in.
Exactly, it's easy.
It's
healthy. Yeah. So see, we drizzle a bit of.
This abracadabra is like ready.
Ready to go. Exactly. That you just put a little bit of paprika. Mm-hmm. You put a little bit of. Parsley.
There we go.
And then just a couple of these little chickpeas.
On top.
Just to make it pretty.
There you go.
And that.
That's about it.
That's our. And you serve it with, I like to serve mine with crispy pita, so we can toast some and give it a try.
Sure. Here you have it, you guys, homemade hummus made by lovely Sherry. And let's dig in.
Let's try it.
You try with me.
Okay.
Ooh, look at this
here.
Look at how hot and creamy it is. Look at that.
No, I'm good. You get more.
There you go.
Nice.
Nice.
Cheers.
Mmm. So creamy. Mmm. I can taste the garlic. Mm-hmm. Nice. Mm-hmm. Simple to make. Very simple. Very nice.
And healthy. Mm-hmm. It's very healthy.
Especially when you toast your pita bread like this.
Yeah, exactly.
I make it crunchy. Can you hear the crunch?
I can hear it. Make me hungry.
So good.
So good. Mm-hmm. Well, you guys, it's very easy to make. You can make it at home, as Sherry showed us. And please make it, send a picture to us. Sherry and I, we both want to see your own creation of hummus. Awesome. And but until next time,
cheers.
Thanks for watching, you guys. If you like this video and you want to see more, please subscribe the channel and leave a comment below. I love to read your comments.